So, but what's interesting, and I feel what you're saying right now, because I feel like my art is also changing.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all kind of getting freed. And probably something has to do with being programmed for so long. Like, I was a hockey player from 5 to 35.
Wow.
Like,
yeah.
So it's not, you know, people become professionals at 20, right? They become comics or singers. Now, I was doing it since I was 5. And then at 35, I was like, okay, no, I'm not going to do it anymore. But this whole journey, and I can sort of feel it, like I don't want to tuck my shirt in that much anymore. You know?
That's exactly what I'm saying.
Yeah. And I'm like, there's this vibe kind of happening, and I'm fucking, and I can feel it happening in my work and in my confidence. And it's, yeah, you're right.
That's great cool. For acting.
Yeah.
Okay, that's great for comedy.
Yeah.
Because in sport, you tell me if I'm wrong, you obviously improvisation is great.
Yeah.
Look at Pat Mahomes.
Yeah.
Right? I always think a lot of athletes are stifled because the system doesn't kind of bend to a brilliant, like, right. Athletes are artists.
Yeah.
Okay, they're no different than painters. So, but would you say in athleticism, you have to be so precise?
Yes, it's very difficult to play that loose sort of organic game. Like, let's see what comes to me, and then I'm going to sort of make moves off of that.
Mm-hmm.
It's very focused. Like, have you watched Hard Knocks yet this season with Aaron Rodgers?
I haven't watched Dad or Oppenheimer.
It's so good because
I've watched Barbie.
It's so good because Rodgers is... He's where I feel like where I'm at, he's kind of at, but still in the game. Like, he's loose.
Yeah.
But it's still so dialed and focused. And I can see him already starting to make this transition. Like, the first scene of Hard Knocks is him walking out of the practice facility, and he taps his mic and he says to the sound guys, "How's the volume? How's my sound?"
Mm-hmm.
You know? That's a fucking showman.
Yeah, no, he's also, I would believe that was, I mean, obviously he's brilliant, but one of the reasons is because he was always denied. They made him go through so much to get to the fucking league.
Yeah.
From JUCOs and fucking,
yep,
starting, and then he's got movie star looks.
Yep.
And he's just, when you watch him, I just
And he's also a freedom fighter.
Yeah, big time.
Let's not forget.
Yeah, he is.
Let's not forget.
He is. I love
he's
that.
He's one of the fucking guys.
Yeah, he is.
And you can put 5, 6, 7 names on the board.
Yeah, he's one of them.
And he is I just got goosebumps. Fucking, let's go to the New York Jets.
Yeah, dead serious.
Like, let's see him
win
a Super Bowl.
I agree. When they fucking came for him,
yeah,
I thought, you're all scum.
Yeah.
You're scum.
Right.
Like, the NFL...
Yeah.
And all the ESPN pushing people to get the fucking poke.
Yeah.
And you're assisting fucking murder.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Can I say that?
I mean,
fuck, dude.
I think
the NFL is like, oh, this guy hasn't got it. Do you know who plays in your league? There's a few people with fucking 187s.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Undiscovered 187s. But they're like, hey, man.
Yeah.
I think the NFL is full of shit.
But you know what's beautiful? He didn't back down. He put his foot
didn't.
On the gas.
Yeah, he did.
He said, okay, I'll go on Rogan. I'll go on Lex Friedman. I'll go on anybody's. I'll go on all the big dogs show.
Mm-hmm.
He went. He ran into the burning building. He is a fucking New Yorker. It's like sometimes people, they get traded to New York, a New York team, and it either clicks for them or it doesn't. You know, it works. Like a Johnny Damon or some of the Yankees that have come and they just get New York. They get the people.
Mm-hmm.
And they fucking immediately are loved. He's got the opportunity to put Namath's legend on the back burner.
You're right.
And that is
that's insane.
That is a big fucking claim.
That's like...
Because Joe was...
You could argue Mount Rushmore. Well, it's a Mount Rushmore moment. You know what I'm saying?
The white fur, the interviews.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's very... It's so interesting because I think right now it's so obvious that the stuff that's working, the things people are drawn to are all the real ones, are all the things that whoever they are don't want to be successful, like the Sound of Freedom.
Yeah, bro. I did a whole pod about that.
Oh, yeah.
Did you see that?
I saw clips. I saw clips on it. Did you release clips on it, I think?
I did some
comments
on I just
what do you think? I mean, did the people speak?
Yeah, I mean, it's almost made $200 million. It's made completely outside the system. It got no press, and people were actively trying to take it down. Now, you don't have to like the people involved.
No.
You don't have to like the filmmakers. You don't have to like whatever, the actors. But you can't disparage a movie that's putting out that message because you're going to look like a fucking weirdo.
Yeah.
You're looking weird. Because at the end of the day, I talked all about this. It's what art should be is talk about the darkest subjects and make them palpable.
Right.
Palatable. No one's ever made that movie.
No.
Okay. And people say they made Taken. Taken was an amazing movie, but it was Hollywooded.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? This was a dark story. So the fact that people were disparaging it because of other reasons, that's fucking weird.
So how many Academy Awards did Traffic win? A lot, right?
Yeah.
This had a very Traffic vibe to me.
Yeah.
Like the quality of how well that movie was made and shot.
It's a great comparable.
And some of the performances, and we're not talking, you know, Traffic had a stacked cast, but it just, fucking awesome for everyone involved in that movie that took a chance and just said, we're going to make it.
I think Jim Caviezel is the bravest actor in Hollywood.
Yeah.
And
he's a wild man.
No, but he has success multiple times against the grain.
Yeah.
And dude, he's also been in Legacy. He was in The Thin Red Line.
Yeah.
He's worked with J-Lo. He's done big Hollywood things.
Yeah.
This is still a big Hollywood thing. Hollywood doesn't want it.
Yeah.
This movie's made $200 million.
Well, by the way.
In this summer.
And how much? And I hope Jim put 15, 20 in his own pocket of that 200. I hope he had a deal. He must have made a shit ton of money on it.
I hope so, too.
And because he deserves it.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you got to have big balls to take shots like that.